In order to find the resultant force using the parallelogram law of the three muscular forces acting on the pelvic bone as shown in the figure, we can start by first figuring out the resultant of two of those forces and then utilizing the resultant force and the third force to calculate the resultant of all three forces. So to start, let us consider our first force of 80 Newton that is acting at an angle of 30 degrees from the horizontal x-axis, and the second force of 60 Newton acting along the y-axis. Now drawing that thing on xy-axis, we can start developing our parallelogram by translating our force of 60 Newton to the head of the 80 Newton force. Similarly, we want to translate the force of 80 Newton by moving its tail to the head of 60 Newton force and developing our parallelogram. Once that is done, the diagonal of this parallelogram will give us our resultant force. Let us label that thing here as FR1. Now with the diagonal, our parallelogram is divided into two triangles. We can pick any one of those triangles and solve for the internal angle to utilize our cosine and sine law to solve for the resultant force FR1. So let us separate the bottom triangle and draw it separately. We have our resultant force FR1 of the two forces of 80 Newton that is making a 30 degree from the horizontal x-axis and 60 Newton acting in the vertical direction. Now let us label the internal angle between the force FR1 and 80 Newton as alpha. Since the 80 Newton is making a 30 degree from the horizontal axis, that can be reflected along the internal angles on the head of it. Next, since 60 Newton force is making a 90 degrees from the horizontal, the combination of these will give us an internal angle between the force 80 Newton and 60 Newton that is coming as 120 degrees. Once we have the internal angles, we can apply the cosine law. That is, the resultant force FR1 will be equals to the square root of our first force 80 Newton squared plus the second force of 60 Newton square minus 2 times 80 times 60, and the cosine of angle between these two forces, that is 120 degree. Simplifying, we get our resultant force of 121.66 Newton. Now once we have the resultant force, we can also figure out the angle alpha utilizing our sine law. So as the sine law state that the sine of angle divided by the side opposite to it will be equals to the sine of the second angle of the triangle and the side opposite to it as well. In this case, that is our resultant force 121.6. Now we can get the value of angle alpha by simplifying and taking the sine inverse of 60 times sine of 120 divided by 121.66. Simplifying, we get the value of alpha as 25.28 degrees. Now, once we have the value of alpha, that is the internal angle between the force FR1 and 80 Newton, we can identify which the angle our resultant force is making from the horizontal x-axis. That will be alpha plus 30 degrees. That is equals to our 55.2 degrees along the x-axis. Now, once we have identified the resultant of our two forces, next we can draw and repeat the same process, drawing our parallelogram between the force FR1 and our force of 120 Newton that is acting on the pelvic bone. So let's go ahead and start applying the parallelogram law one more time between our two forces. So to start, again drawing our axis x and y and drawing our force of FR1 of 121.66 making an angle of 55.2 degrees from the horizontal x-axis. Next, I have a force of 120 Newton And instead of the angle, we are given a right angle triangle on the force having the hypotenuse of 13, the base of 5, and perpendicular of 12. So we can calculate the angle it makes from the horizontal axis by calculating the cos inverse of the base, that is 5, divided by the hypotenuse, that is 13. Taking the cos inverse, the value is coming 67.3 degrees. Now, once we have identified both the forces, magnitude and angles, let's go ahead and draw our parallelogram. And we'll do it in the same manner by translating our force of 120 Newton and putting the tail of it on the head of 121.6 Newton force. Similarly, we have to translate our second force of 121 by moving it and putting the tail of that force on the head of 120 Newton. This way, we make our parallelogram. Now, to figure out the resultant of these two forces, the diagonal of this parallelogram will give us our resultant force. Next, we can go ahead and pick any one of the triangles from this parallelogram and figure out its internal angle and the force Fr utilizing our cosine law and sine law. So here I'm going to select the bottom triangle and let's draw it separately. I have a force of Fr, that is my resultant force, that is the resultant of our force 121.6 Newton and a force of 120 Newton. Now this 120 Newton force was making an angle of 67.3 from the horizontal axis, whereas our force of 121.6 is making an angle of 55.2 degrees from the horizontal. Next, the complementary angle of the force 120 Newton can be calculated by subtracting 67.3 from 180, that is coming 112.7 degrees. Now, once we have the angle between the two forces of 121.6 and 120, we can go ahead and start applying our cosine law to figure out our resultant force Fr. So our cosine law goes by Fr will be equals to the square root of our first force square, that is 121.6, plus our second force square, that is 120, square minus 2 times the product of the two forces and the cos of angle between them. Here the angle will be the sum of 112.7 and 55.2, that is coming 167.9. Now simplifying, we get our value of Fr as 240.3 Newton. This is the resultant of the three forces acting on the pelvic bone. Next, to find the angle this force will be making from our horizontal x-axis, we can first go ahead and find the internal angle alpha utilizing our sine law, that states that the sine of the internal angle alpha divided by the side opposite to it of 120 will be equals to the sine of the second internal angle of 167.9 divided by the side opposite to it. In this case, that is Fr of 240.3. Simplifying, we get the value of alpha as 6.01. Finally, the angle our resultant force of 240.3 Newton will make from the x-axis will be the sum of the angle 55.2 degrees plus the 6.01 degree that we have just calculated, and that sum is coming 61.21 degrees.